Hey, this is Russell, back again with another episode, and yeah, we are exploring here. This is the post-commentary on this game that you see on the screen right now. I completed this game a few weeks back. No, actually like a little more than a month ago, I think, but yeah. And yeah, people are building roads. Building settlers, building all the stuff that you do when you're expanding in the beginning of the game. We have a lot of islands still pretty open right now, but those are going to be taken fast, especially because there are a couple of civs that do have map making. I'm not the only one. Which is going to make things a little tricky. You know, it's going to be a race for the islands. And yeah, so I have another settler ready. I do have one city, as you probably saw last time, on one island. And yeah, I'm producing workers and cultivating land. Made a mistake there. You want to build irrigation on those tiles. Because if you already have like so many hammers on a tile, when you're in the despotism phase, I think it's despotism. Well, when you're in this phase of the game, you don't get any more hammers by adding more hammers to it. So food is the way to go. Also, we want to take care advantage of the fact that they've irrigated up to our border for us. You know, because it's right next to irrigation, we can irrigate that land. So may as well get that irrigation and spread it. Going in a boat there, loading the spearmen in a boat, almost disbanding them though, because the keys are pretty close to each other. And yeah, we get our special book, which is really great against fighting like the barbarians early on. I don't see us really doing early war, or me doing early war in general in this game. I'm not that experienced at it yet, so especially because I'm playing like a difficulty up from the last couple of games I played. And yeah, that's not good. A settler already on this island, and they're trying to put a city like smack in the middle too, which is pretty annoying. So the goal would be here to try to box them out as I try to think what I'm going to be building. Harbor maybe? Yep, there you go. Harbors are good. We need to connect the network of cities up. And I was thinking, like, maybe, you know, I could, like, keep moving to find, like, a better city spot, but it's better to just unload my dudes here, try to box them out from going south. That's my iron, you know? And I don't think I have iron on the main continent, so securing that iron is pretty important. Having a bit of a hard time exploring here. And look, they're going for that iron also. So fortify, build Trebizond. And we got the iron and the sugar. I think that's sugar. But yeah. I don't know why I'm queuing military. I can guess why. I need to probably secure, box them out more. And yeah, I'm sailing around with my Kuras. I think they're pronounced that way. Kura. But yeah, so it's been cool uploading these videos. Thank you guys for comments, support, and stuff like that. It's I plan on playing this game a lot more, so if you're interested in these kinds of games like Civ 3 and stuff like that, of course, subscribe and wait for me to upload the next ones, because I'm not planning on stopping uploading these anytime soon. So yeah, got my worker, and he is going to irrigate the desert, I guess. So my spearman's walking around. I probably already lost that ruin. Because, you know, settler. My poor Kura sank. Not a big deal. More money for me, I guess. No, that ruin's still there. So there we go. And another settler coming down. And it's going to be a little while before I have another settler. Like, you see that one up there is going to be 15 turns. I don't have any other ones queued besides that one. And it looks like I will get that ruin. What is it going to be? Warriors. Well, not my problem. They're next to the enemy city, not mine. And, yeah. So there's a whale down here, a sugar, an iron. There's a lot of stuff down here. A fish. So the southern half of the island is pretty good. I believe the enemy is settling up there because they're trying to get the whale up there since they didn't get the iron. And they don't want to settle too far away from their main area. Which makes sense. I don't know, like, if the AI is incentivized to settle nearer to them. But, because I don't know much about the AI. But it would make sense if it was that case. Because the closer you are to your capital, or closer you are to your Forbidden Palace, the less debuffs you get on your city. I also like, in this game, unlike in other versions of the game, like Civ 5 and stuff like that, you can rebuild your palace in like other cities. Like make another city your capital instead. I always thought that was kind of neat. To be able to like change your capital around and stuff like that. And realistic too, if you think about it, because the capital wasn't always, you know, Moscow in Russia. It was like St. Petersburg at times or whatever. And yeah, it just makes sense because people change that stuff. And yeah, my boat. He has to go back to see if he can bring anyone else across. But you know, he's not going to be able to bring someone across anytime soon. Settler for another 13 turns. And wha-bam! Chowstone. What am I going to queue up here? A worker. That makes sense. I probably need a lot more workers on that island. There's still quite a lot of land on that island. Unfortunately, I don't think that island... I might have to go there again. I don't think that island has a river on it. So irrigating is going to be annoying. Of course, the Spanish are still colonizing the island that we're on. They have all of that nasty tundra tiles. Those nasty tundra, not tundra, ice tiles, or tundra. I forget what it is in this game. Below us. Actually, I don't think they have, like, do they have, like, the black tundra tiles, or is it, is, like, tundra and snow, like, the same thing in this? I think it's the same thing, but I'm unsure. Yeah, it looks like they don't have, like, any of, like, the other style tundra trials. Like, snow and tundra are the same thing in this game. Makes sense. No, I do not want to delete my irrigation. What are you thinking, Russell? And I got my spearmen walking around. Republic is the next thing in queue. Which, you know, I think is the best thing to go for next. Tech-wise, I'm falling a little bit behind some people, looks like. Everyone has mathematics that I don't have. I have a lot more than the Koreans do, so I'm able to trade for some good stuff. Get some more gold stocked up. Babylon is way behind everyone, for now at least. That's what happens if you don't explore, you know? Selling to get a little more gold to stay ahead. So long as I can keep everything like to the max with my science, it's worth selling that. For him, he only has 8 gold, so it's not really worth selling him anything. And 94 gold, but that's the Spanish. And I don't particularly want to, like, sling up the Spanish in technology. And, yeah. I've still kept my science at 100% for now, which is pretty big. that signs up. Mind you, I don't have too many commerce producing tiles in my empire, so doesn't do crazy good. I built some walls. I don't know what to expect in terms of like getting like attacked. Cause I know the AI starts with like buffs and stuff, but I don't know like how much more they're incentivized to like attack me at this point in the game. So I know like when you get to like certain difficulties, like in Civ 5, you get like declared war upon like all the time. Because they always assume that you have like you're weak compared to them, even when like you know you have a really defensible position and everything. But yeah, here in this game, I noticed they don't declare war on you very often. Usually, the reason for them declaring a war is if like you like refuse to give them like a technology or gold that's stronger than you. Which I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. I mean, obviously, I like the game because I'm playing like the game right now and stuff like that. But yeah, I just don't know how I feel about that mechanic in particular. Looks like they're landing more settlers on the island. The race is on. I have a couple settlers queued at this point. And I have my eyes on where that fish is. It's my next to location. Doing some exploring. And I got a new worker there. And I queued up another worker immediately. Working all the tiles is pretty important. So, doing that. Standard exploration. I've explored a huge chunk of the map. I'm pretty proud of myself for that. Like, it's pretty tempting to like just sit there and not explore after a certain extent when you've scouted out like your city locations. And especially like in Civ 5 where like tech trading isn't nearly as important and stuff. Like, you know, you can't do tech trading like that. I'll sometimes like explore and then like just like stick to my local area. But in this game it's much more important to explore because like, you know, I'm acting as a broker now for a lot of these different technologies. It's what's keeping me on par with everyone in tech. Another settler, maybe? Not? Maybe? I don't know. Archer? Yeah, a settler wouldn't work because 6 turns to produce a settler and 10 turns to grow. You have to have 3 pop in order to be able to finish your settler. Because it takes 2 to finish it away. And yeah, moving my worker there. It's my source of horses. I don't think I have like anything on the other continent, like no horses or iron. But I have a couple sources of those there. Actually, I do have a horse on the main island. There we go, next to Adrianople. But yeah, I'm gonna build some roads. I think what the roads do is it connects your network of luxury resources, so it spreads the happiness, and that's why you also have like harbors as well for those places that are farther away. The Spanish did get this bigger slice of the pie when it comes to continent, but I think I got like the best real estate on the continent, on the area. You know, there's a lot of like resources on my half of the island, a good variety of terrain for both hammers and food, and they're just stuck with tons and tons of grassland. And snow, basically. So yeah, we got a pretty good portion of the island there. I have my eyes set on that island next. The one with the horse, the 2 fishes, and the whale. The one that my Kura's kind of sailing around. I'm thinking about settling that one next at this point. It's just, you know, a good spot to keep expanding to. It would be much harder to try to expand like northward, and it would be kind of far away, like up to where I'm looking now. I mean, there's a lot of land there, yeah, but it's just hard to get there, and then it would be hard to defend as well. Well, I have a direct sailing path to the next island because of the island that I settled, big island that I've secured a few cities on between it. If I was to expand northwards, I would essentially be cut off from that land until I could sail across the ocean. And then even then, it would take a while to get there. So, yeah, I'm not sure if I'd explain to everyone at this point. I'd have to open the diplomacy menu again and count. I don't think I have discovered everyone though at this point. It's hard to get past like the borders of these different empires without pissing them off. So that's kind of what I'm trying to do by not like staying a turn in there, because then they'll like ask me to leave and be unhappy and everything at me. And yeah, and harbor. Not sure why I'm building a harbor there, because I'm pretty sure I already built a harbor on that continent. Maybe a harbor does something else. What does a harbor do? Look, I'm reconsidering now, which is smart. I think harbors are mainly just network things. I'm not automating my workers this run, at least right now. Maybe I do it later if I don't remember, but right now I'm not automating my workers for sure. I have a feeling I'll fall behind if I do. Got a dude queued. Settler, maybe? If I was right, living right. Yep, settler. That's good. Playing right now, I would do settler. Settler produced, which is good news. Temple. What am I gonna do here? Oh, I already have a drillman there. There we go. I'm smart. Now I'm considering going up there. I'm thinking about it. I'm looking at that island over there. Looks like I'm distracted. Yep. And I'm trying to go my way down the southward. And yeah. I have a dude that I'm moving down south. Spearmen that I'm fortifying, maybe? Nope, I'm moving them. Probably to see if I can block them off. That warrior's still just sitting there, which is pretty precarious for my worker. Got a sugar. And expanding the culture on that city, I see why I'm doing a temple. Get the whale and the iron if I can expand the culture in that city, so temple is, yeah, a good idea. Settlers finished there as well. So I'm going to be able to settle a couple cities. And that one is going to be aiming to go there, which is a pretty important place to secure. And you'll notice I have a couple more settlers queued. Running a bit out of real estate now. At least down here. Yeah, I'm not sure why I built a mine on that sugar. Like, maybe it was a good idea. I'm not sure. I'm going there because I really want to make a run all the way back. Connect that to the wider network. Got a lot of sugar in this network. And then I think a spice as well. These guys want map making. I give it to them. I'm not looking for any trouble. They're way behind us in tech, though, so they probably weren't even that much of a threat. It's still just one of those things where, you know, you gotta be careful. And yeah. That warrior's moving down, which is not good. So I go ahead and take a defensive position, protect my worker. And I got a new settler ready, but I don't think I have a boat to deal with him. So right now he's just going to have to sit there until one of my boats come back. And queue it up stuff. So yeah, again, thank you guys so much for watching. And got a nice trade here. Nice. Give me some money, maybe. Oh. Lots and lots of money. Close. I like money. I like money. This deal will probably be acceptable. Yep. Perfect. And these guys want it for free as soon as I get it. But yeah, make sure you guys like the video, comment, let me know what you think, favorite, and all that. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. It's a blast recording these, you know. I mean, it's one of those things where, like, I play this game anyways, and I'm just recording it. So, it's cool to go back and do a bit of a post-commentary on it, and then upload it and get your guys' advice on stuff. Hopefully I can become a better player through reading you guys' comments and stuff. And hopefully I'll be able to bump up the difficulty one day to something that's even more exciting. This is already me living life on the edge by playing at this difficulty level, so. But yeah, one day I'll be able to challenge myself a little more, and looking forward to that. Got a few more moves left before this turn is over. So then my dudes go everywhere. Settlers go in there. And yeah. Building some roads. I don't know why I didn't build a road there. I don't know what I'm doing with those workers. Yeah. So much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. I'll probably record the post commentary for the next one pretty soon, actually, probably the same day as this. So yeah, sail away. Like, favorite, and subscribe if you guys want to see more. Always interested in your feedback down in the comment section. You guys have a good one. God bless.